What is Astro? And by that, I mean several things. What is Astro for? When is it a good idea to use Astro? And when is it not? What problem is it trying to solve? In other words, what is Astro's why? It's raison d'être, as the French would say. Before we go any further, in order to research Astro and understand how it works, I actually rewrote my personal website with it at codeapps.dev using one of the templates that Astro provides. Now, what is Astro? It might be easier to start defining what it is not. Astro is a JavaScript framework, but I hesitate to call it that. Why? Because people immediately assume that we mean a front-end framework, one intended as an alternative to React and the like. Astro is something else. It works with front-end frameworks in collaboration and not in competition with them. It doesn't aim to compete with Next.js or Remix either, although these two do address similar use cases. And it's refreshing to hear Astro's creators state that no, they don't want to address every single need. And no, there are situations where Astro is not ideal for the job at hand. Because Astro is a tool that targets a particular use case, publishing content-focused websites. What does that mean? Well, to understand that, we'll be going over Astro's features, its strengths, and its weaknesses, such as Astro's old-school page rendering model and what use case Astro targets, Astro's developer experience, or DX, Astro's complexity you can opt into, and how Astro goes about creating pages that load fast, and the islands of interactivity model. But first, let's look at the rendering model. React and other front-end frameworks entrust HTML rendering to the browser. This allows for a richer user experience because the state is managed locally on the client. But this comes at the cost of more JavaScript shipped to the client. But what about all the web pages where there is no state to speak of? All the blogs, the landing pages, the news websites and so on that make up a large majority of the web. The pages that focus on content, not on interactivity. These are the use cases that Astro aims to serve. Astro's goals are the opposite of React's. Astro defines itself as a multi-page application, or MPA. To any server developer, that sounds like reinventing PHP's Laravel or Ruby on Rails. And that is precisely what Astro aims to do. When Astro was announced, people commented that generating pages on the server felt outdated and old school. Fred Schott of the Astro team responded, "Exactly, that was a good model that we moved away from because the developer experience was so poor. PHP or Ruby on Rails or even Python all require you to master another language, whereas Astro uses JavaScript, which you need for front-end development anyway. So in a sense, Astro is a server for front-end developers. But why not just use vanilla HTML? Well, HTML is for markup, not for programming. Astro updates HTML with reusability via components, with logic, with a JSX type syntax, although you don't need to use React's class name attributes, just class works. We can use variables and conditions and maps on arrays to add logic to our HTML code. In short, Astro brings a Next.js-like developer experience to HTML authoring. It doesn't primarily provide client-side logic to HTML authoring, though. Astro files, that is to say pages and components, have two parts. The first is the server-side code, between three lines of hyphens like front matter on Markdown. Then comes the front-end HTML code. This allows Astro pages and components to read from files on the server or to fetch data from a backend, such as a header CMS, to create the page. Astro also supports Markdown and MDX. This means that users can author content in a copywriter-friendly format. Now, at first glance, Remix and Next.js serve the same purpose as Astro. But Astro removes all the front-end complexity by default. Why? Because it doesn't care, by default, about the state on the client. Astro's default behavior is static site generation, or SSG. Any server-side rendering, SSR, is optional. Choosing between the two is done when you configure the deployment. Are we deploying to a static environment or to a compute one? This means that managing state, be it client-side or server-side, is an option, not a requisite. Astro does away with all the client-side JavaScript, unless instructed otherwise. This means that the pages it produces are light and load fast. I can already imagine people saying, but I really love React or Svelte or Solid and Vue, And so do I. Otherwise, I wouldn't be running a channel that talks so much about them. But more to the point, so does Astro. You can plug components from any of these frameworks into an Astro page or into a component. All it takes is an import statement. But what happens here is fascinating. By default, Astro ships no JavaScript to the browser. None, zero, zilch. The components themselves are not interactive. Astro renders the component tree server-side and publishes the resulting HTML. But what if I need interactivity? Well, Astro allows you to opt in to client-side interactivity on a component-by-component basis. As I mentioned, the default behavior is no interactivity, no JavaScript. But if you wish to or if you need to, you can opt in to client-side interactivity. Astro will then ship the relevant JavaScript to the client. In fact, you can specify when you want the component to become interactive or to hydrate. To do so, Astro provides a set of directives. If you want the component to be interactive when the page loads, add the client load directive to the component. For the component to load whenever the page is idle, use client idle. And if you want to wait for the component to actually be visible, use, you've guessed it, client visible. And you get the best of both worlds, with page load optimized based on your use case. In that sense, Astro makes React work even better. But do we really need another framework to learn? Well, of all the frameworks that I've been able to use over the past years, Astro is the one with the softest learning curve, the one that feels the least like another framework to learn. And to me, that's its strongest selling point, how little there is to learn. The HTML is vanilla HTML with a bit of logic and reusability added. The server code is basic server-side JavaScript. And that makes sense because the meat of the innovation of the work in Svelte, in React or Solid or Vue is about how they manage the state. If you do away with the state, everything becomes much simpler. Of course, there are ways to share the state between components on the client side in different trees and even from different frameworks. You can either use a baked-in solution called Atoms, or you can rely on Svelte or on Solid. But that complexity linked to state is optional depending on your use case. This makes Astro a perfect platform for people wanting to create simple pages or people learning HTML, JavaScript, or even front-end frameworks. Astro isn't yet suited for every single use case, but that's fine. However, it is astonishing how many use cases it does cover, how agreeable the developer experience, the DX, is. And I, for one, am going to be spending more time exploring this new framework, tool, server, whatever. And if you're interested in learning more about this exploration, well, I'll see you in the next video.